Good morning and welcome to you all. I trust that you have had a good week and that you have a lot to look forward to as we enter into another week and as we celebrate Thanksgiving. Welcome to you all once again. We turn to God, thankful for all that is good. We turn to God and cry out for all that is wrong. We turn to God, asking for help and restoration. We turn to God with aching hearts and glad souls. Let us worship God. The hymn, "For the Fruit of All Creation," Voices United 227. Praise and thanks to you, O God, for your acts of love and faithfulness toward us. In your mercy, you hear our prayers. You forgive our sins. You provide for our needs. From one end of the earth to the other, you inspire worship and praise. Even nature celebrates your goodness. And so God, inspired by this time of worship, may our hearts overflow with praise each and every day, and may our lives reflect our gratitude to you in the ways we share your abundant love. In the name of Jesus, amen. My friends, God offers us reconciliation and newness. Let us together confess our sins before God and pray for forgiveness. Let us pray. Generous and loving God, we confess that in a world where many do not have enough, we enjoy more than we need. In a world where many live in fear, we take peace for granted. In a world where many have lost hope, we become indifferent to despair and grumble about small things. Forgive us, merciful God, and transform our lives to shine with generosity, peace, and hope that you offer to us in Christ Jesus. Amen. The hymn, "Now Thank We All Our God," Voices United 236. Joined together by the love of Christ. Let us now share the love we have in Jesus as we receive greetings from some of our members.
Ron? Hello, Trinity. Ron and I miss you and hope everyone is well. We also want to extend our thanks to Reverend Sydney and the entire team who puts together our online worship services. That's something we watch every Sunday and look forward to, and we appreciate very much your leadership in that initiative. Thank you.
The video.
Good morning on this Thanksgiving weekend. I just want to say how much I miss everybody, and I can't wait until we get a home of our own where we can flourish like we're meant to do. Keep safe, keep well. Goodbye.
Thank you all for sharing your greetings. Our scripture reading for today will be read by Ken Summers. Let us pray for understanding as we prepare to receive the readings for today. Let us pray. God who speaks, as we gather to listen to scriptures read and proclaimed, may we hear your voice, and in hearing, may our lives be transformed by your grace. In the name of Christ, amen. Our first reading for today is from Deuteronomy chapter 8, verses 7 to 18. And as I said, Ken will lead us in that reading.
For the Lord your God is bringing you into a good land, a land with flowing streams, with springs and underground waters welling up in the valleys and the hills, a land of wheat and barley, of vines and fig trees and pomegranates, a land of olive trees and honey, a land where you may eat bread without scarcity, where you will lack nothing, a land whose stones are iron and from whose hills you mine copper. You shall eat your fill and bless the Lord your God for the good land that he has given you. Take care that you do not forget the Lord your God by failing to keep his commandments, his ordinances, and his statutes, which I am commanding you today. When you have eaten your fill and have built fine houses and live in them, and when your herds and flocks have multiplied and your silver and gold is multiplied and all that you have is multiplied, then do not exalt yourself, forgetting the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, who led you through the great and terrible wilderness, an arid wasteland with poisonous snakes and scorpions. He made the water flow for you from flint rock and fed you in the wilderness with manna that your ancestors did not know, to humble you and to test you, and in the end to do you good. Do not say to yourself, my power and the might of my own hand have gotten me this wealth. But remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth, so that he may confirm his covenant that he swore to your ancestors, as he is doing today. God still speaks. Thanks be to God.
It's up to us to be the change. There is a place we're all connected. Each of us can find each other's light.
Our second reading for today is from Luke 17, verses 11 to 19.
Jesus cleanses 10 lepers. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 lepers approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean? But the other 9, where are they? Was none of them found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then he said to him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." God still speaks. Thanks be to God.
As we celebrate Thanksgiving, let us remind ourselves that every day is a day of Thanksgiving. More Voices, 185.
Lord, today.
Gracious God, you still speak to us. And may we hear you now as we listen to your Spirit's leading and prompting. In the name of Christ we pray. Amen. Thankful living. Tomorrow, we will be celebrating Thanksgiving. It's going to be different this year. It will likely be scaled back quite a lot. But nonetheless, families will sit down to sumptuous meals. We will reward ourselves, those of us who can, with the bounties and fruits of the harvest. We may even remember those less fortunate than ourselves and give something to them. And all that is good, very good. It is good to feast and celebrate and to share the bounty of the earth and the beauty of life with loved ones and friends. It is good to set aside a day to rejoice and express gratitude for the goodness of God and of others. When we give thanks as a community and as family, we are reminded of the source of all good things. We are reminded of the grace of God, of God's undeserved favor. And we remember, if only for a moment or a day, that we have been blessed. We remember that there's more to life than just ourselves. And that is good. So I say to all of you, happy Thanksgiving. But as good as all of that may be, God calls us to much more. God calls us not only to a day of thanksgiving or to moments of thankfulness. God calls us to a life of thankful living, which is a whole different thing. A life of thankful living is more than just the occasional expression of gratitude that we extend when we feel that the situation deserves it. It is a continuous embrace of gratitude. It's a way of life. As children, we were taught to say thanks whenever we received something or whenever someone did something for us. But the truth is that we have been taught to say thanks as a matter of courtesy so that we won't appear to be ill-mannered. But living a thankful life is not just a matter of being courteous. Nor is it just about an occasion that we celebrate. It's about how we live. There are some things that characterize a thankful life. For one, a thankful life is a life that recognizes the good. Now, we all know that everything in life is not all good. We have had bad experiences. We have encountered bad people. But in spite of how bad things may be, a thankful life is able to recognize the good amidst all of the bad. Now, that is not to say that a thankful life does not acknowledge the bad. It is not to say that it lives in a state of denial, our world of make-believe, where it pretends that everything is great in the hope that by so pretending, it will somehow change the reality. A thankful life is not that. Rather, it is a life in which one understands that everything is not always going to be the same way. It's never about one experience only. Life is never about only the good or the bad. It is always a mixture of both. And the truth is that no matter how many or how terrible may have been the bad things that have happened to us, none of us would be here today had it not been for the many good things that we have also received. When we look at our lives, we may see setbacks and disappointments, but our lives are not failures. We may not have accomplished all that we wanted to, but the good thing is that we did achieve some things. We may not be where we wanted to be, but we could have been worse off. We may not have failed, or rather we may have failed at some of the things that we set out to accomplish. But the good thing is that we have learned from those experiences. We may not be as strong and healthy as we would like to be, but the good thing is that we are still able to enjoy life. Some may treat us badly, but there are others who understand and care. In the novel Robinson Crusoe, the main character by that name found himself on a deserted island. The first thing he did was to make out a list. On the one side of the list, he wrote down all his problems. On the other side of the list, he wrote down all his blessings. On the one side, he wrote, "I do not have any clothes." On the other side, he wrote, "But it is warm, and I don't really need any." On one side, he wrote, "All of the provisions are lost." On the other side, he wrote, "But there's plenty of fresh food and water on the island." And down the list, he went. In this fashion, he discovered that for every negative aspect about his situation, there was a positive aspect, something to be thankful for. My friends, we sometimes find ourselves in difficult situations, but the only way we can survive is to take an inventory of our blessings. What are the things for which you are truly thankful today? A favorite hymn of many is that hymn that speaks of counting our blessings. When upon life's billows you are tempest tossed, when you feel discouraged, thinking all is lost, count your many blessings. Name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done. Thankfulness is a choice. We may not be able to control the experiences that we face, but we can control how those experiences affect us. We can choose to focus on the bad and become depressed, or we can choose to focus on the good and be encouraged. When we are thankful, it means that we have made a choice to focus on the good. You know, one of the great hymns of the church is that hymn of thanksgiving that we sung earlier on. Now thank we all our God. A Lutheran pastor, Martin Rinkarp, wrote this hymn in 1637, at the time of the 30-year war in Germany. The city in which he was pastor had become a shelter for refugees seeking safety from the fighting. As the war progressed, the city was surrounded by invading army. Food supplies dwindled. A famine hit, followed by a terrible plague, and the city became a place of death. In that single year, over 6,000 people in that city died, including his wife and all of his children. He was the only surviving pastor in that year alone, in that city. And in that year alone, he conducted over 2,000 funerals, including the funeral of his wife and children. And remarkably, it was in the midst of that catastrophic personal and social loss that Pastor Rinkard wrote that great hymn of thanksgiving. Now thank we all our God with heart and hands and voices, who wondrous things has done, in whom his world rejoices, who from our mother's arms has blessed us on our way with countless gifts of love, and still is ours today. My friends, when we live a thankful life, we are able to cope with the worst of situations, and we do so by choosing to focus on the good things and being thankful for them. A thankful life is a life that recognizes the good, even in the midst of the terrible things. A thankful life is also a life that acknowledges God. In our gospel reading, we read of 10 lepers. As Jesus entered the village, this band of 10 lepers sought him out. As a group, they approached him with the words, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." And Jesus responded, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." Now, as the 10 lepers were on their way to the priests, something happened to them. They were healed. 9 of them accepted Jesus at face value. They saw him as the one who reached out to them and offered them healing and a new chance at acceptance. Those 9 went to the temple in confidence, sure that the priests would declare them to be clean. But one of the 10 lepers did something more. As he traveled to the temple, he recognized that he was healed, that his life had been transformed by Christ. So he turned back to give thanks. like the other nine. He was told to go and show himself to the priest. But he understood that the priest can only bear witness to what Christ had accomplished. The priest may declare him clean, but the cleansing comes from Christ. He understood that the source of his healing was Jesus. So he returned to the source. My friends, there are persons like the priests in this story who have played and will continue to play important roles in our lives. And we should acknowledge that and be thankful for such people. But whatever good they may have done for us, God is the source, the ultimate source. Others can help us to get where we are going. Others can help us to accomplish what we set out to accomplish. Others can help us over the difficult periods of our lives. Others can help us to feel good about ourselves. And we should be grateful for such people and acknowledge their help. But we must never forget that the source, the ultimate source of all the goodness that we receive, is God. It is God who gives us strength to cope. It is God who sustains us by God's grace. It is God who renews us in his love. It is in God that we live and move and have our being. And therefore, we should always be thankful to God. For God is the source of every blessing. And thanksgiving leads us to that source. And so, my friends, as we gather with family and friends, as we feast and celebrate, let us remember to thank God. And I pray that the spirit of thanksgiving will extend beyond today and tomorrow, and that we will thank God in every situation and at all times. I pray that beginning today, ours will be lives of thankful living. For when we look at where we are and all that we have received, we will see that we do have a lot for which to be thankful. Thanks be to God, and happy Thanksgiving to all of you. Let us join in offering our prayer of thanksgiving. Let us share in that prayer. Let us give thanks to God for all the blessings we share this day. Thanks be to God for the gracious care and generous provisions which we enjoy in this beautiful country. For freedom of speech and of the press. For the avenues to express ourselves and for opportunities to effect change, we give God thanks. We pray for all who are voiceless victims of unjust governments. Grant them, O God, freedom and dignity. For fertile soil, abundant rain, and seasons of refreshment, we give God thanks. We pray for those whose lands are parched and whose wells and rivers are dry. Bless them, O Lord, with plenty. For our families, friends, and the church, who provide us with love and support, and who help us to sustain life, to enjoy life, we give God thanks. We pray for those who are hungry and tired, alone and hopeless. Help them, O God, to find support and community. For healthy bodies and minds, and for opportunities to grow, we give God thanks. We pray for the sick, for those who are unable to participate in and enjoy life as they would like. Grant them strength and wholeness. And help us, O God, to be responsible stewards of your blessings. May we always respond to your call with a true spirit of generosity and thanksgiving. Amen. Thanks be to God. The hymn, "As those of old their first fruits brought," Voices United, 518. Friends, go with gratitude and humility for blessings received. Go with joy and peace for love shared. Go with hope and trust in God for what is to come. Be joyful and thankful. Fill your minds with those things that are good and deserve praise. Things that are true and noble, right and pure, lovely and honorable. Put into practice what you have heard today. And may you experience the God of love and peace, now and always. Amen.